Honorable members, I am delighted to address this first session of both houses of parliament after the elections to the 16th Lok Sabha. Let me begin by extending warm greetings to my fellow citizens who participated in large numbers in the recently concluded Lok Sabha elections. We should never forget that we are here because of them. Serving them should be our first priority. I also felicitate the members of the new Lok Sabha. You have successfully obtained the mandate from the electorate, and now you represent their hopes, aspirations, and dreams. I extend a warm welcome to all of you and hope that the sessions ahead with heavy legislative agenda will be productive and useful. It is a matter of great satisfaction that the recent general elections were smooth and largely peaceful. I would like to congratulate the Election Commission of India and the official machinery for conducting these elections successfully. The unprecedented interest shown by the people of India in the elections is a sign of progressive deepening of our vibrant democracy. Before I dwell upon the tasks ahead of us, I would like to express my solidarity with the families of all those who lost their lives during the election process. I congratulate the new Speaker of Lok Sabha on her unanimous election to this august office. By successively selecting women speakers, the Lok Sabha has reaffirmed our age-old belief in the importance of women in our society. Honorable members, this has been an election of hope. It marks a turning point in the evolution of our democratic polity. The surge in aspirations and the belief that these could be realized through democratic process has been amply reflected in the record 66.4% participation by voters and a clear verdict in favor of a single political party after a gap of nearly 30 years. The electorate transcended the boundaries of caste, creed, region, and religion to come together and vote precisely in favor of development through good governance. Honorable members, the country needed a strong and stable government that could provide effective leadership. In my Republic Day speech earlier this year, I had hoped for 2014 to be a year of healing after the fractured and contentious politics of the previous years. Standing here today, I applaud the wisdom of my fellow citizens for having voted for stability, honesty, and development in a resurgent India in which corruption will have no place. They have voted for a united, strong, and modern India, Ek Bharat, Shrestha Bharat. My government will work to fulfill these aspirations with the involvement of all the 125 crores people of this great country. My government is committed to nurturing the right environment of actualizing this mandate of the people. For this, it pledges itself to the principle of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, which can be fulfilled only through your active participation. We will work together to re-establish the credibility of the institutions of democracy. My government will function on the mantra of minimum government, maximum. In all our actions, we will be guided by the core values of our great civilization. Honorable members, my government is dedicated to the poor. Poverty has no religion. Hunger has no creed. Despair has no geography. The greatest challenge before us is to end the curse of poverty in India. My government will not be satisfied with the mere poverty alleviation and commits itself to the goal of poverty elimination. With a firm belief that the first claim on development belongs to the poor, the government will focus its attention on those who need the basic necessities of life most urgently. It will take necessary steps to provide security in its entirety to all citizens through empathy, support, and empowerment. Containing food inflation will be the topmost priority for my government. There would be an emphasis on improving the supply side of various agro and agro-based products. My government will take effective steps to prevent hoarding and black marketing. It will reform the public distribution system, incorporating best practices from the states. My government is alert about the possibility of a subnormal monsoon this year, and contingency plans are being prepared. Despite more than two-thirds of our people living in rural areas, we have not been able to provide adequate public amenities and livelihood opportunities to them. My government is committed to improving the quality of life in our villages through empowered Panchayati Raj institutions. A substantial part of investment will focus on creating community assets and improving basic infrastructures such as roads, shelter, power, and drinking water. My government will strive to end the rural-urban divide, guided by the idea of Rurban, providing urban amenities to rural areas while preserving the ethos of the villages. Agriculture is the source of livelihood for majority of our people. In the recent past, our farmers have been under severe stress, with hopelessness driving some of them to suicides. My government is committed to reversing this unfortunate trend. It will increase investment in agriculture, both public and private, especially in agri-infrastructure. Steps will be taken to convert farming into a profitable venture through scientific practice and agro-technology. My government will address issues pertaining to pricing and procurement of agricultural products, crop insurance, and post-harvest management. Productivity of animal husbandry will be increased. My government will incentivize the setting up of food processing industries. Existing cooperative sector laws will be reviewed to remove anomalies and lacuna. My government will adopt a national land use policy which will facilitate scientific identification of non-cultivable land and its strategic development. Honorable members, each drop of water is precious. My government is committed to giving high priority to water security. It will complete the long-pending irrigation projects on priority and launch the Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana with the motto of Khor Khet Ko Pani. There is a need for seriously considering all options, including linking of rivers where feasible, for ensuring optimal use of our water resources to prevent the recurrence of floods and drought. By harvesting rainwater through Jal Sanchay and Jal Sinchan, we will nurture water conservation and groundwater recharge. Micro irrigation will be popularized to ensure per drop more crop. Honorable members, India is the world's oldest civilization. Today it is also a country with the largest population of the youth. We must equip and nurture our youth with the right kind of education, skill set, and opportunity to reap this demographic dividend. My government will strive to transition from youth development to youth-led development. It will set up massive open online courses and virtual classrooms. It will formulate a national education policy aimed at meeting the challenges posed by lack of quality, research and innovation in our educational institutions. We will set up IITs and IIMs in every state in order to empower school teachers and students. A national e-library will be established with the motto, Har Hath Ko Hunar. My government will strive to break the barriers between formal education and skill development and put in place a mechanism to give academic equivalence to vocational qualifications. With the goal of skilled India, my government will also launch National Multi-Skill Mission. The children and youth of the country need avenues of recreation that develop them constructively and keep them fit. My government will launch a national sports talent search system. It will facilitate development and promotion of Indian sports, particularly rural sports. Sports will be popularized by making it an integral part of the school curriculum and providing educational incentives. Our country needs a holistic healthcare system that is universally accessible, affordable, and effective. To achieve this objective, my government will formulate a new health policy and will roll out a national health assurance mission. It will promote yoga and Ayush to address the shortfall of healthcare professionals. Health education and training will be transformed. AIIMS like institutes will be established in every state in a phased manner. We must not tolerate the indignity of homes without toilets and public spaces littered with garbage. For ensuring hygiene, waste management, and sanitation across the nation, a Swachh Bharat mission will be launched. This will be our tribute to Mahatma Gandhi on his 150th birth anniversary to be celebrated in the year 2019. Keeping in mind welfare of the people belonging to scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, other backward classes, and the weaker sections of our society, my government will take steps to create an enabling ecosystem of equal opportunities in education, health, and livelihood. My government is committed to see that those belonging to the scheduled caste and other backward classes are able to avail emerging opportunities. For the scheduled tribes, my government will launch a dedicated Banbandhu Kalyan Yojana. Electrification of tribal hamlets and connecting them with all-weather roads will be a priority area. It is unfortunate that even after several decades of independence, sections of minority communities continue to suffer from poverty as benefits of government schemes do not reach them. My government is committed to making all minorities equal partners in India's progress. The government will specially strengthen measures to spread modern and technical education among minority communities and a national madrasa modernization program will be initiated. The welfare and rehabilitation of specially abled people is integral to my government's vision of a caring nation, society. It will take steps to provide dignity of life to them by facilitating their participation in all walks of life. Steps will be taken to identify their special needs and to provide institutional care to them. My government recognizes the important role our women play in the development of our society and growth of the nation. It is a commitment to providing 33% reservation to them in the parliament and state legislative assembly. With a commitment of Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, my government will launch a mass campaign for saving the girl child and enabling her education. It will structure a comprehensive scheme incorporating best practices from states in this regard. In the recent past, the country has witnessed some gruesome incidents of violence against women. The government will have a policy of zero tolerance for violence against women and will strengthen the criminal justice system for its effective implementation. Honorable members, India is a federal polity, but over the years, The federal spirit has been diluted. The states and the center should function as an organic Team India. In order to actively engage with the states on national issues, my government will reinvigorate fora like National Development Council and the Interstate Council. The center will be an enabler in the rapid progress of states through cooperative federalism. State-specific development models will be developed, taking into account the special needs and unique problems of coastal, hilly, and desert areas. Highest priority will be accorded to bring eastern region of the country on par with the western region in terms of physical and social infrastructure. My government is committed to addressing the issues relating to development of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. The government will lay special emphasis on improving the intra-region connectivity and border infrastructure in the northeast as well as Jammu and Kashmir. The issue of infiltration and illegal immigrants in the northeast region will be tackled on priority, and all pending fencing work along the northeast border will be completed. Special efforts will be made to ensure that the Kashmiri Pandits return to the land of their ancestors with full dignity, security, and assured livelihood. Honorable members, my government is committed to providing a clean and efficient administration focused on delivery. Installation of Lokpal is important to curb corruption, and my government will endeavor to formulate rules in conformity with the Act. My government will take steps to build the confidence and morale of our civil bureaucracy, enabling it with the freedom of work and welcoming innovative ideas. The government will stress on putting in place transparent systems and time-bound delivery of government services. Government system and processes will be revisited to make them citizen-friendly, corruption-free, and accountable. Efforts will be made to eliminate obsolete laws, regulations, administrative structures, and practices. Rationalization and convergence among ministries, departments, and other arms of the government will be ensured to have focused delivery. Digitization of government records will be done for improving accessibility. E-governance brings empowerment, equity, and efficiency. It has the power to transform people's lives. The backbone of my government, new ways of working, will be a digital India. Information technology will be used to drive e-engineering of government processes to improve service delivery and program implementation. We will strive to provide Wi-Fi zones in critical public areas in the next 5 years. My government will roll out broadband highway to reach every village and make all schools e-enabled in a phased manner. Technology will be used to prepare our children for a knowledge society. The National E-Governance Plan will be expanded to cover every government office, from the center to the panchayat, to provide a wide variety of services to citizens. Emerging technologies like social media will be used as a tool for participative governance, directly engaging the people in policy making and administration. My government is determined to rid the country of the scourge of corruption and the menace of black money. As a first step in this direction, the government has already constituted a SIT to unearth black money stashed abroad. This will be followed by vigorously by proactively engaging with the foreign governments. Keeping in mind that justice delayed is justice denied, my government will adopt a multi-pronged approach to address the problem of high pendency of cases in our judicial system. It will progressively modernize the courts to improve their operational efficiency and start a reform of the criminal justice system to make dispensation of justice simpler, quicker, and more effective. It will initiate a mission merge project for filling vacancies of the judiciary and for doubling the number of courts and judges in the subordinate judiciary in a phased manner. The government will give special emphasis to the development of alternate dispute resolution mechanism. Honorable members, on the economic front, we are passing through an extremely difficult phase. For two consecutive years, our GDP growth has been less than 5%. Tax collection has declined. Inflation continues to be at an unacceptable level, thus putting the Indian economy back on track is paramount for my government. We will work together to usher our economy into a high growth path, rein in inflation, reignite investment cycles, accelerate job creation, and restore the confidence of the domestic as well as international community in our economy. My government will create a policy environment which is predictable, transparent, and fair. It will embark on rationalization and simplification of the tax regime to make it non-adversarial and conducive to investment, enterprise, and growth. My government will make every effort to introduce the GST while addressing the concerns of states. Reforms will be undertaken to enhance the ease of doing business. My government will follow a policy of encouraging investments, including through FDI, which will be allowed in sectors that help create jobs and assets. For rapid creation of
Z24 तास रहा एक पाउल पुढे.